All right, last but not least, in terms of the osteology, we're going to talk about the foot. And here we have an articulated foot that includes tarsal bones, metatarsals, and phalanges. And you have a very similar organization as to what you had in the hand and the wrist. But instead of 8 carpal bones like we had in the wrist, we're going to have 7 tarsal bones. But in comparison, these are considerably larger. And that has a lot to do with the amount of weight that's going to be on these bones at all times. So even when you're sitting, you still have weight there, and of course when you're standing or locomoting. So let's talk about the tarsal bones first, and I'm going to turn to a medial view so you can get a better view of the two largest bones. The most superior of your tarsal bones is your talus or your talus bone. This is what's really forming the ankle joint. So you'll have your tibia right here. You'd have your medial malleolus of your tibia here and the fibula right here to form that hinge joint that occurs at the ankle or your talocrural joint. So that's going to be the most superior one here. Then in terms of right below it, you have your calcaneus. This is the largest of your tarsal bones. A lot of times we refer to this bone as the heel bone because this is this portion right here is really what you're standing on when you're standing on your heel. Your Achilles tendon or your calcaneal tendon is actually going to attach right about in this region. Okay, so those are 2 of the tarsal bones, and then you're going to have 5 others. You'll have your navicular, which is kind of ship-shaped. That's what it gets its name from. Your cuboid right here. And then you're going to have 3 cuneiforms. You'll have your medial, intermediate, and lateral cuneiforms. And sometimes you hear these referred to as first, second, and third cuneiforms. Now I'm going to turn this back to a medial view, and I want you to see that with these bones, they're organized in a way to give what we refer to as arches. So arches are important in terms of the spring that you have in your step, and particularly your talus, calcaneus, and these more posterior tarsal bones, your navicular, as well as your cuboid, are really playing a role in terms of forming those arches. Okay, like we had in the hand, you had metacarpals in the palm region. We're going to have metatarsals in the foot region. And you can see that the first metatarsal is going to be the most robust or the thick. Second, third, fourth, and fifth metatarsal. And I'm going to turn this to a lateral view now. And you have a styloid process associated with your fifth metatarsal. And you're going to have muscles attaching here, fibularis muscles, that if you have some type of tear in that tendon, it can cause for this region to become avulsed or torn off. So a fairly common injury there. Now, let's think about in terms of the organization of digits. We organize them from first through fifth. If you think about in terms of the hand, your first digit is associated with your thumb. And recall that your thumb is going to be laterally placed. So first, second, third, fourth, fifth, all right? But that's going to be different in the foot. The first digit is associated with your big toe or your great toe, similar to what we're thinking about with the thumb. But think about, is that going to be medial or lateral? Your big toe is going to be medial. So your first digit is going to be medial. Second, third, fourth, and then your fifth is going to be the most lateral. Now you're going to have phalanges, and you're going to have the same amount of phalanges, 14 phalanges. Similar to what you had in the thumb, you're only going to have a proximal and a distal phalange for your first digit, no intermediate, whereas you have a proximal, intermediate, and distal phalanges for digits 2 through 4. Now in comparison, you can see that these the phalanges are not quite as robust, not as fully developed as what you have in terms of the hand, which is not true for the metatarsals. You can see these are fairly long in comparison to what you had in the metacarpals.